Good morning. I welcome you all this morning in this August gathering of the Tour Guides of Israel on the eve of the Armenian centenary of the genocide of 1915. Just in 3 days, we will officially commemorate that tragic event, not only here, but also in Armenia and all over the world, where there are Armenian communities. As tour guides, it is incumbent upon you, of course, to present history in reality to the many tourists that visit this holy land. In a way, you represent the official aspect of the Israeli government. So what you have to represent should be factual. We, the Armenians, are part and parcel as a community of the Holy Land Society. We have been here for 1700 years, and we have gone through many turbulent times as a community and as an Armenian church. The last and the biggest one has been this tragedy of the genocide that took place in the Ottoman Empire when Palestine was part of the empire. And 1.5 million Armenians were killed in many different and horrible ways. Many nations have recognized the Armenian genocide, some 22 or 23 of them so far. But there are a lot more that still have to recognize it and force Turkey to recognize the guilt of its ancestors in perpetrating this genocide. On April 12th, His Holiness Pope Francis I took the bold step of officially mentioning this genocide as the first genocide of the 20th century. And his mention irked Turkey that immediately recalled its ambassador from the Vatican. So Turkey was enraged over the announcement of the pact. I'm glad to say that now Germany will officially recognize the Armenian genocide on April 24th, this coming Friday, in a formal resolution. And the Israeli government has also decided to send a delegation of members of the Knesset to Yerevan to represent the Israeli government. This is a heartening step towards the full recognition by the Israeli government that so far had refrained from taking that step. After all, an injustice was committed against the Armenian people by annihilating them and by depopulating the Armenian villages and towns from their ancestral lands. And as you may well know, this genocide served as a pretext to Hitler, who in 1939, in a discourse, mentioned it and referring to the independence of the world, he said, who remembers now the Armenian massacres? And then he embarked upon implementing his plan of annihilating your people, the Jewish people, in 6 million numbers. So we are sharing history together with our Jewish brothers and sisters in this tragic event. And we look forward to the day when Turkey will come to terms with its past and officially apologize for the guilt of its ancestors that undertook this premeditated genocide against the Armenian people, including other Christians, such as the Pontian Greeks and the Assyrians. I'd like to thank you for coming this morning. I'd like to thank Yitzka and Ruth that organized this event. And I'd like to thank Professor Bernd Bauer for participating in this conference. I wish you good luck and God bless you. Now may I ask you to stand up for a minute of silence in respect of the memory of the 1.5 million Armenian victims of the genocide of the first genocide of the 20th century. Thank you.